Please get ready for exercise number 23 and 24 from Progressive August 2018. 5 seconds. Start. Sir, I would suggest for the consideration of the House, and this is what we have been attempting to do in our science and technology plan also. We should have plan of developmental application of rural technology. Only a few days back, a new friends from the Bangalore Institute of Science came to see me. They said that they had formed a team of scientists at the highest level who are teaching in that institute. They said they decided to go to a village about 70 miles away from Bengaluru and settle down there and then identify the problems there, trying to find out how science and technology could be applied for the purpose of removing backwardness there, for the purpose of improving the productivity, for the purpose of bringing about a better environment there. They have had some short-term experience in functioning in the village. They told me that they were encouraged very much, not only by the results which are coming out of their experiment, but by the response from the scientific community. It is obvious from this, perhaps, that each high-level scientific, technological or technical institution should be asked to take over a specific area and concentrate their efforts there to find out how science and technology could be applied for the purpose of better development of that area and to increase the productivity. Therefore, it is only science and technology which could provide the answer to remove this backwardness. And it is on the basis of this alone that we would be able to tackle many of the problems with which we are confronted, whether it is unemployment or the removal of poverty, particularly in the rural areas. So this is the answer for that. The honorable members talked about rural indebtedness. Rural indebtedness is also due to the feudal traditions which have been allowing bonded labor and other things. All these will have to go. And it is not merely this indebtedness, but also the exploitation of the rural poor by the private moneylenders, which has to go. My honorable friend pointed out this thing. As far Bihar is concerned, it is a coal mine area. I recently went through a report. This person knew something about what was happening there, how the coal miners were being exploited by a set of organized money lenders and other antisocial elements. You talk about protecting the labor and protecting the poor, but have you gone there? Have you tried to organize and see that these malpractices are removed? Therefore, there is no use blaming others if we have not done anything about it, and to that extent we also contribute to the deterioration of the situation there. Therefore, it is a challenge to all of us. There is no use of throwing blame on somebody if the private moneylender is going to lead to this sort of exploitation of rural poor and even of the industrial labor, then we have got to sit down and think about it, how to abolish it, how to eradicate this practice. When we talk in terms of removing rural indebtedness, it is not by moratorium. Of course, that is a part of it, but it cannot stop there. We have to proceed further. You should have organizations to cater to the needs of these people. There also, they want to continue in the same old tradition. How do these people get indebted? They get indebted because they want to imitate the rich in performing their marriages. They want to have the same funeral ceremonies. They want to have the same birth ceremonies, and therefore some of their indebtedness starts with this wasteful expenditure. Therefore, the social customs is a thing which stands in the way. But for this social custom, who sets the pattern? It is the rich people, even the educated people, who set the pattern. Therefore, if we want to remove the rural indebtedness, and if you want to remove the root cause for this, then all of us will have to respond to this and set an example to the poor, because they would look respectable only when they perform the marriage in a certain style. Because we are doing the same. When we talk about the rural indebtedness, let us not attack the rural indebtedness in isolation, unless we attack the social customs which lead to the wasteful expenditure. Even this rural indebtedness cannot be tackled in an effective way. So it has to be looked at as a whole and not in isolation. We should look at it from that point of view. It is the educated group, the richer section of the people, who spoil the poorer sections by their own wasteful expenditure. I'm coming to dowry. When we talk about it in the International Year for Women, we are thinking of liberating the women. Can we liberate them from the dowry system? Who are the worst sinners in this dowry system today? Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, I rise to support the bill as it proposes to amend the Constitution in a manner so that the most important and the urgent need of our people may be included in our Constitution as fundamental rights. Right to work is the essential condition of our existence as a human being. You know, sir, through work, man distinguishes himself from beast and develops his capability to be the master of his fate and control the nature and build up the civilization. This power to work helps him to control the nature and to use it in his interest. He produces his bread and thus continues his existence. Without work, how can a man earn his livelihood? So it is absolutely related to the question of his existence. But today, this existence of man is challenged in our country. The unending queue of unemployed people is increasing day by day. There is no security of his existence, as he has no means of production at his disposal. In a developing country like ours, the unemployment problem is the most burning problem. Stop.